Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the studio. So today I was at the grocery store and I thought, you know what? What I really want for supper is oxtail stew. So I picked up an oxtail and I had the butcher chop it up for me. And so the butcher ran it through the bandsaw and cut it into much more manageable pieces. And at the big end of the tail, they cut it in a couple of different directions so that it's easier to cook. Now, oxtail is pretty much exactly what it sounds like. It is an ox's tail, or traditionally it was an ox's tail. And oxen are castrated bulls, castrated bulls of the cattle species, just like a regular cow, except the bull, that's used or traditionally was used as a draft animal, a working animal. And so by the time they were done working, the meat was really tough, but the tail was fantastic. If you're buying oxtail today in North America at a butcher, chances are it's just regular cattle tail. And there's the very tip of the cattle tail. It's just regular cattle tail, not from an oxen, not from a working animal. So I'm sure the flavor isn't as strong as it might have been a couple hundred years ago when it was a working animal, a much older animal. But the flavor is still amazing. And in a long, slow braise, it breaks down. And the sauce that it creates is just so unbelievably unctuous. But I haven't made it in a long time. Because just like everything else at the grocery store, the price of oxtails is creeping up. And they are becoming something that is more and more difficult to find. There's only one grocery store close to us that I can get them at. So I've salt and peppered them. I'm going to heat up some oil in the bottom of this Dutch oven. And I'm going to toss a little bit of flour in with the oxtails. And we're going to brown these off. And just like any time you're browning, don't crowd the pot. Just put a few in at a time. That's about half. And just let them settle and brown really well. Now, of course, with browning, we're not trying to cook it all the way through. We're just trying to brown the outside and start developing flavor. So I think these are pretty good. I'm going to take them out and set them aside while I cook the rest. Okay, I think that's brown enough. So I'm going to pull the rest of the oxtail out. Then I'm going to put in the aromatics. And for aromatics, I have the classics. Onion, celery, and carrot. They're going to be the first ones in. And check the oil in your pan. If you need extra oil, put some in, but I don't need any. So in goes the celery, carrot, and onion. And I'm not trying to brown it. I just want to soften the onion and get that to start to get a little bit of color, just a slight amount. Next in is some minced ginger, minced garlic, okay, the ginger and garlic are really starting to smell really fragrant. Next in is this, and this is chopped up scallion. I'm using a Jamaican scallion, and just the bottom part, the white and purple part, the green parts I'm going to save until we serve the dish. And so this is a Jamaican scallion. It's purple at the bottom and they're not perfectly round. They grow in clumps and so they'll all be clumped together. The flavor is really nice, a little bit different than a regular green onion. Next in is some tomato paste. About half a can, I guess. I'll put that in and just start to cook it a little bit. I don't want to overstate the amount of cooking tomato paste needs. You just want to start to caramelize some of the sugars. And if you don't do this step, it's not that big of a deal. It really isn't. There are so many celebrity chefs and internet chefs that tell you that you have to cook out the rawness or you have to cook out. And I used to believe that, and I used to do it religiously. And then I've tried it different ways and realized it really doesn't matter, especially in a dish like this, where it's going to be a long, slow braise in the oven. That caramelization is going to happen over the 3.5 or 4 hours that it's cooking in the oven. So at this step, it's not that big of a deal. So if you just plop it in and move on, you're fine. You're going to be totally, completely fine. Next in, I like a little bit of heat. So I'm putting in 2 Scotch bonnet peppers. I'm not going to cut them up. I'm just going to leave them whole. In they go. I've got some allspice, and I'm just gonna put it in this mortar and pestle and give it a little bit of a crush. I'm not gonna grind it too fine, just enough to break it up. In that goes. I'm gonna put in about 4 cups of water at this point, just so nothing burns on the bottom of the pan. Now, I'm using water, all water, but you could use a mix of water and stock. You could use all stock if you wanted to, all vegetable stock if you wanted to. The flavor you're gonna get out of this oxtail is going to give you a super rich sauce anyway. So adding that extra flavor with a stock isn't really worth it all that much, but it's really nice if you replace some of the water with beer or some of the water with wine. That will give you an extra level of flavor that you're not getting just with water. Straight up, water all on its own works just fine. Next, I'm going to put in some soy sauce, about a couple tablespoons. And you don't have to be over the top with your measuring. A couple tablespoons of soy sauce. And then, of course, because I'm cooking meat, in goes the Marmite. And if you live in a Vegemite country, Vegemite works just as well, if that's what you want. I'm going to put that in. This just amps up that beef flavor. And I use it all the time. And I know that there are people out there who are skeptical of using it. And I read the comments, and I've come across quite a few comments of people saying, against my better judgment, I went and bought a jar of Marmite, and I used it in my stew, and it tasted amazing. So it's really good. Next up, some thyme. And I'm just going to strip the leaves off and put them in. The really fine stems right at the end. They're fine just to put in all on their own. You don't have to chop them up. There you go. The last one, put that in. Next up, this is our homemade Worcester sauce. Now, I made this in September 2019. And it is now April 2021, and it smells amazing. It is coming into its own. It's not a fully brewed substitute for Worcester sauce, but it has all of the same elements, and it does the same thing. It really pumps up that beef flavor. So I'm going to put in a good dollop into the pot. Again, building flavors. The last 3 ingredients, the Worcester sauce, the soy sauce, and the Marmite are all about building up that beefy flavor, which really helps you if you've only got a couple of hours in order to cook this. I've got a bit of time today, so I'm going to let it really slowly braise in the oven. But if you're pressed for time, these really build flavor. So back in goes the oxtail. You'll notice I'm not putting in any potatoes or any other root vegetables. I'm going to leave those out. I like to pour this over top of a mashed potato or a rice or mashed plantain, something like that. Okay, so lid on and into the oven. Now I've got the oven preheated to 325 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm gonna stick this in here and I'm gonna let it go for 3 to 4 hours. I will once or twice take the lid off and give it a stir, check on the amount of liquid, and if I need to add liquid, I'll put in a little bit more water, or I might spill in some beer at that point. See you back here when it's done. Okay, this has been cooking for about 3.5 hours. So I'm gonna pull it out of the oven and put it back on the stovetop. I'm gonna check how thick it is. I've got one more addition that I wanna put in, which are some beans. And I'm gonna use fresh soybeans, edamame, if you will. I'm going to stir those in. And you could use any kind of bean or pea that you like, but I like these big B beefy soybeans. And we also at this point want to check and see how thick it is. If we want it a little bit thicker, you can just stir in a little bit of beurre manier. And I've used beurre manier in the past on the show. It is just equal parts of butter and flour mixed together. That's what I've got here. And so what happens is the butter surrounds the flour. So when you put it into the sauce, the flour doesn't clump up and you get a real good thickening of the sauce. So I'm going to start out by putting in maybe a tablespoon. I've got this on a medium heat, so it will come back up to a simmer. I'll simmer it, I'll stir it, and I'll add a little bit more beurre manier if I need to thicken it up even farther. But it only takes a couple minutes to thicken the sauce. This is also a good time to fish out those hot peppers. Don't leave them in the stew. There's one more. No one wants a surprise hot pepper on their plate. There we go. Two hot peppers. Okay, so I've got some mashed potatoes, and I'm just gonna put taste out for us.
Woohoo, mashed potatoes! Hey, hey friends, hey Glen.
Oxtail soup stew.
Okay, goes perfect with mashed potatoes. I can see why they go together. It'll always soap up all that
and so
that stewiness.
Put a little bit of sauce on the side. Some scallion tops, just to add a little bit to it.
Is it okay if I start with the potato right away?
You can start with the potato. I'm going to go in for the oxtail. Now, oxtail is, or can be, difficult at the table because the bone is in there still.
Those flavors are really good.
That meat is fantastic.
There we go.
The meat is fantastic. Potato in the sauce.
Yeah, that's super tasty. Toss in some more vegetables and I'm good to go.
There's a lot of flavor in the tail. So this is a low and slow braise. Really easy to do. Once you've got everything in the pot, you just forget about it for like 4 hours.
That's the best kind.
And you don't worry about it, which is great. We've got mashed potatoes with it. You can put it with rice. You can put it with noodles. Put it with mashed plantains.
Oh yeah, I can see that too.
Mashed plantains would be fantastic with this. So there's a whole bunch of things you could do with this. And if you wanted to, you could put the potatoes and all of your other root vegetables into the stew and just have a complete stew.
Anything you want.
Yeah. Thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.